This week's Ask Dr. Durie comes from a patient who is very confused about neutralizing antibody testing and the possible need for a booster vaccine. And well, this is very important to understand. First of all, the neutralizing antibodies are the antibodies which attack the COVID-19 virus infection. The antibodies are important to be checked, but the testing has to be the correct test. Unfortunately, there are many, many antibody tests on the market and readily available. And so the important thing is to talk carefully with your own doctor about the specific neutralizing antibody test. The very best testing is only available in a few reference labs across the country. For example, in California, there's a reference lab in Sacramento where samples can be sent. And so it's very, very important just to talk to your doctor rather than just searching the internet yourself. Talk to your doctor and jointly identify the correct testing so that you can see if testing can be done in your case. Testing can be done after the first dose or preferably 2 weeks after the second dose of vaccination with Moderna or Pfizer. The not so good news is that we have learned that for myeloma patients on active treatment, the antibody levels, the neutralizing antibody levels that are achieved are less than optimal, and many patients will have maybe not sufficient antibodies to be sure or secure that any infection will be fought off. And so this is the unfortunate reality in the current situation. And so the first thing to be aware of is that standard precautions need to be continued because of that. Patients need to continue to wear masks, avoid crowds, and be careful about social distancing. But the question is, well, how about getting a booster vaccination to really get a better neutralizing antibody level? And this has been very much in the news here recently, and the Pfizer pharmaceutical company just announced that they will, in fact, seek FDA approval for a third or booster vaccination in the 6 to 12 month time frame after the original double vaccination. And so it seems that maybe this booster vaccine will be available if the FDA does in fact approve this type of booster. It seems that both Pfizer and Moderna will seek this type of approval. What we will need to understand is if this booster is sufficient to get the antibody levels into the safe range that we want to see. And so bottom line is that for the time being, information is really incomplete in terms of the exact levels of neutralizing antibodies that can be achieved in myeloma patients, except that we do know that they may be much lower than we would like. There is definitely a chance that booster vaccination will become available and may be a way to get those antibodies to a level that we would like to achieve. But in the meantime, stay safe, wear your mask whenever you're out and about and might be exposed in an uncertain circumstance.